Tonight on Policing 7, we need your help to find me, a Siren King.
I don't like how you in my best, Maybelline.
So you know the scene, you gotta be in the scene. From the outsider's perspective, they see it as annoying and it's us getting smart. For us Sireners, it's more than just a hobby.
At the end of the day, it's all for the love of self, no matter what. Instead of fighting, we battle, see who's louder.
Lazy Boy started when I got my ride. I had a Ford Explorer, a white one, and I wired up, say, 12 sirens in the front bumper. And I'll drive around with that, and everyone would be like, hey, where's your car, man? Ride, it looks like a fob.
I wanted to go out there and battle with other cars. So I went up and battled Moni. He was a Siren King at the time. No one knew that I was going to battle on the night. I just came, parked up, and I called him out. And I said, oh, I'm keen for a battle for the title. Yeah, I won against him on that night. The first Siren battle happened in 2010. It was out in Mount Wellington. He's two different titles as well. He's the car one, and then he's the bike king. Back in nowadays, when we were doing sirens, we had like a few ups and downs with other crews, but we all ended up being all goods after that. Nowadays, when they come to the battles and that, there's no trouble. Other siren crews, these are SOR, they're out from Mount Roskill, and we have the SWB, they're out from East. The Switchhitters, they're from the Runway. These are other siren crews as well. We got a big siren battle coming up soon. I know it's gonna go off. It's gonna go off big. And then the next day I'll be heading off to Australia and start my new life. Just to go make money, to help out my family. Yeah, because I'm not really doing much here. As far as I know, I haven't heard any young ones getting in trouble since they joined the siren scene. The cops may think that they're stealing them, which we don't know, but there are some stores you can go buy sirens from.
Some of the sirens, when we buy them freshly from the shops, they normally come with security chips inside of it. And for us siren boys, we normally take them out just to make the sound come smoothly. For us boys, we'll call straight original riders. I haven't been with this crew for almost a year now. For us, it's like another family for us. It keeps us out of trouble and stuff. Basically, for me and my two younger brothers over here, this is probably another way for us for staying away from all the violence and all the crime activities out there. Straight Original Riders took us in, and now we found our hobby that we can enjoy. The OGs from our crew, watching them do the stuff like this, and we basically learn off what they do. Looking at sirens, it's a bigger picture. Our future can be better for us. So we don't have crime history on us.
Heaps of boys do this, even like little kids, younger generations than us. I'll be battling the siren battle. I just go see who it was. Once a battle, then just go battle. All for the love of sounds, so it doesn't really matter if you win or lose.
When I head out to the feed joint, could get a cut, clean up from the best barber in Auckland.
We're looking forward for a big event. Man, by far, we're stalling the game, eh?
What makes you think about moving to us?
Trying to find a different life. from the lifestyle in New Zealand. Just want to start fresh, start a new journey. It's gotten to a lot of shit with the police, and then I couldn't change around here. Every time I say I'll change, it never happens, see? I know for myself, if I stay and hang around, I'll probably end up in jail or something, yeah. I just want to make that move now and go start a new life, get away from all the trouble here. Sonny, he's the leader now for the Noisy Boys. Ever since he's been on the team, he's always going out there battling by himself.
My name is Sonny, 19 years of age. Grew up in South Auckland. Joined Noisy Boys last year. Ever since then, been on the team.
So what I got running now, these two, 15-watt noodies, and these ones, 30-watt CSs. So the noodies go kind of like a low sound. When it's playing out, treble in the 30-watt CS, it plays like hyper-G. So it's got to kind of balances it out. So what I got here was the first ever switch I've had in my ride. She's the screwdriver, picked it in, made a hole, chucked the switch through. I was born in town, migrated over in 2004 with my parents. It was back in 2017. Pretty much started buying sirens and doing my own ride, wrecking my bumper and everything now. So my boot, this is pretty much where all the magic works. Got a 12-inch subwoofer. I got my amp running my sirens. And I got my second battery here. It's my first ever hookup. My mate's dad did it for me. And I watched them. And from then, slowly started learning myself. Finally got it now. Good enough for my sirens to work. I had one rule in the team, and that was loyalty. And that was loyalty to their brothers, loyalty to the team, and loyalty to the captain. I want just everyone just to have that close bonding and just their brotherhood, and I guess that's what we're taking into battles. What we're hoping is to make the scene legit and actually find spots for us to actually battle instead of having to play cat and mouse with the cops. I hope that the outsiders actually see like what our point is from us sireners and like what we're trying to get across. And the thing we're doing is not to annoy people, but it's something that we love. Yeah, I just hope that that continues on throughout Noisy Boys. Yeah, everyone doesn't see this bad picture.
If I had heaps of money, bro, I'll get an ice cream truck, And I've already got the sirens there. I'll come to all the battles, ice creams for everyone.
Yo. That's all good. That siren's not illegal, dude.
Yeah. First came from Matonga. I was there until I was 5 years old. When I came to New Zealand, I went to Onanga Primary School. From there, I went to Penrose High School. Got kicked out and then tried to get into other schools in Auckland, which they declined because of my report. This neighborhood is full of Polynesians. Good vibes, happy neighborhood, you know. As you see on the news, other different neighborhoods, they have all these shootings and gang stuff and that. And only hangers, you know, we're just like one big family.
A steak and cheese pie.
Steak and cheese, righto.
Yeah,
thanks,
okay.
Joe.
Okay, you have a good day.
You too.
Right.
Sup, Nonzi?
Kaora.
Yo.
Yo.
Yo. Yo. Yo.
Yo.
Music plays a big part of the siren game. It's nice and loud, and you play like a nice clear vocal, Celine Dion or a nice
pitch voice. Some of the boys came around, we started doing some recording. And then they were like, hey, you should be the guy that's making our beats.
My little homies on the rise, hold it down for the hood. Yeah, we hold it down, hope patrolling through the hood. My little homies hold it down, on the grind for the hood. Yeah, we hold it down, put in work for the hood.
Hey, sup, dogs?
Sup, dogs?
What are you up to?
Just getting up from the comedy center.
Hey?
Yeah.
So I've packed up some of the stuff here.
Oh, yeah.
Big mouse, big mouse. You get the money. See the honey? No.
What are these, dogs?
Oh, these are the ring.
Sure.
The hood rings. Ew.
Kazakis.
Mm. Yeah. See to Auckland. On the hang on the middle.
Yeah.
Yeah?
Nice.
Married to the hood. Yeah. Everywhere I go, the hood's off me.
Forever,
yeah?
Forever.
Styler?
Styler, dogs.
No, dogs.
No way.
Last cover before you go, eh, Docs?
Yeah.
It's gonna be ultra different when you're gone, dude. You're like, hey, where's that original noisy boy?
Yeah.
Oh. Full moon, eh?
It was good, baby.
Tonight we're heading up to the siren battle. Yeah, I'll be one of the judges for the night. Most of the boys from Noisy Boys will be battling too, but I won't be judging them. I'll judge some other crews and that.
So this is the photo for tonight. One of the boys that passed away. He passed away last week on Friday. He was an OG of the scene, he was a role model to me. Battle for tonight's for him. Maybe one of their family members was to hold it. Yeah, he was like harder looking forward. But dang, that's sad.
Yo.
Yeah. Right here. Yeah. Yo.
Four cents only this year, my boy.
Look at me, do you think I can buck around on a bike?
These guys, they go high.
Yeah, that's us.
Noisy Boys means like a lot to me since they took me in. And they were just the crew that was around. And then they just wanted to take me in because I was the loudest bike out there. We're just going to head on down to Sinza Park just to just have fun. And just share for sirens. Put all my hard work into it.
Finished having a leaders meeting, and all the leaders are gonna go tell their crew and that to all come together, and we're gonna have a moment of silence for the late lost ones of the siren crew.
For those who don't know, we're here on behalf of Aoso, who was a leader of Notorious. He was part of the scene, he worked his ass off for the scene, and he shone in the scene. And should you not, the scene has grown so big. Look at us now. This is pretty wicked. But for him to bring us all together, it means something. Doesn't matter what hood you're from, doesn't matter what color you bang, we're all family in the scene. From OGs to newbies. All these beefs, all this talk, bro, cut that shit out. We all gotta grow up, we all gotta mature. Some people here are fathers and mothers. We all family up in here. And that's what this scene is about. It's about the love of sound. Let that sink in. I rip my hood hard, I rip my club hard. Cause that's where my heart is. People outside of the scene look at the scene differently. They look at it like, oh, look at these bombs. To us, it's like, that's what I do best. The battle's tonight. It's all gonna be friendly, it's all gonna be humble. I hope God looks over you all. Alphas.
All the best here on battling tonight. Full sin, but also, love you most. Long live the real fucking boss, eh?
Man, just look around, like the people around here. It doesn't matter what color or where you're from, but you're here for music and everyone loves it. It's not fake, it's real. This is our life.
That's the thing with the siren scene. Even though we're all different crews and stuff, it's always brothers before everything. You get real positive vibes. It's, you know, it's always a positive scene. There's ups and downs, but we're all just one. And the way we settle things up is to battle.
30 seconds each song.
Yeah.
Doesn't matter what song you play.
Yeah.
It's based on who's loud and clear.
Yeah,
not,
yeah.
Not just clear, yeah. And not just loud.
Yeah.
Next time.
You know, win or lose, should be happy because it's all for the love of sounds, you know. I see it as a big family, eh? All coming to meet at that one spot on Friday night. That anticipation of just getting there, just flicking that switch, hearing that echo.
The same thing as usual. If the person takes the two battles, it is no need for a drown out. Yeah, but if you have one battle each, then yeah, there'll be a drawn out 1 minute. First round, we will have Toysy Boys of that one. You're my caffeine in the morning. Got me feeling like I'm a second one, we'll go to SOR. So now we have a drawn out battle to see which car is louder than the other. All right, you won that one, eh? Drawn up, big time.
Just around with everything, everyone here. I will miss the scene, but you know, we'll still have some in Australia, hopefully, with some of the boys there. But it wouldn't be like to see a different scene.
Gap already. Passport, yo, check. Oh, bring the other bag.
Should be it. Love you, Dad. Okay. Fuck. It's not really hitting me right now that I'm moving to Oz. I've got family around me and the boys. Probably later on, when they all gone home, it'll probably hit me. In Australia, I knew it would make a big difference for me in a good way. It would change a lot. But there, I knew it would just be me and my cousin. We'll just do our thing, work, save, and send money back home. It's the whole drive right now.
Oh, yo, on behalf of the team, shot for everything, eh?
Yeah.
We'll continue your legacy over here.
Knowing that I'm leaving the legacy behind for everyone, it's something that us and all the ones started. I'm thankful that these guys are willing to carry it on.
Onehanga means family to me. Just the only place that shows real love, eh? Can't find any love like this around anywhere else. Sentence your life in Onehanga now. Be here forever.
Stranger to me, minor setbacks ain't a major for me. Cause when we come back, you know we raising the fee. Who are you? Who are you? Don't give me daps, you a stranger to me. Minor setbacks ain't